back to Cowabunga Corner, and in this episode, we are here with Leif Tilden, who is the body actor, main actor for Donatello in Turtles 1 and 2. Yes. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Of course.
What inspired you to get into acting?
I went to the experimental theater wing at NYU. I was interested in alternative dance and acting. Went to NYU and studied with all these crazy cats who were a big part of American theater in the late 60s and early 70s. And Ping Chong, Robert Wilson, Drzy Grotowski, all these like people that were very influential in alternative, American alternative theater, experimental theater.
Did you do any costume
work before
being a turtle?
No.
No? You had no experience with that beforehand?
No.
What other hobbies do you enjoy?
I like to eat. No, I like to cook. I like to garden. I like to listen to music. I like sitting on the couch, watching television, like everyone. I like beer. I love to travel. Okay, so I love to travel.
Traveling is fun.
I do a lot of traveling. I've coached soccer and baseball, Little League baseball.
What was your first acting job? Did you get any?
My first acting job was while I was still in college. I was asked to be in this play in San Francisco with this director that I admired at the time, Joseph Chaykin, who had a theater company in the late 60s called the Open Theater. And he asked me to come out to San Francisco to the Magic Theater in Fort Mason area of San Francisco to put together an original play that was developed in rehearsals and things like that. That was my first, I was paid for it.
Now, before you worked on a turtle movie, have you ever heard of Ninja Turtles before that?
This is an interesting question, because I had, but peripherally, like I'm not focused in on it, but I knew of it. And I knew that it was underground, kind of dark, you know. And then I got this audition for the Turtles, and so I started researching, right? And I actually made, for the audition, I made an original bow, a handmade bow. I went to the hardware store, got like a dowel, and painted it, and did all this on the rooftop of my apartment in Chinatown. So, but then, like, I went to the audition, and they said, no, you don't need the stick. And I was like, okay. But one of the things I did for research is that Chinatown is near the East Village, and I used to hang out in the East Village in New York. And I went to this underground comic book store in the East Village, asked the guys about the Ninja Turtles, and they're like, hey, come on over here. Yeah, it's great. It's cool. And I got this, it was black and white, old underground comic, and they were vicious. It wasn't at all Archie Comics.
Yeah.
It was they were vigilantes, it was crazy.
They were actual ninjas, assassins.
They were assassins.
Yes.
They were vicious.
Trained to kill the Shredder.
Yeah. It was cool. I was like, oh my God. And then, so I was kind of jazzed about it, because I was like, oh, this is cool, you know. And then it became something completely different. It was like Archie Comics and, hey, Donnie! It was different than I thought it was going to be. But it was fun. It was fun. Anyway.
Tell us about your trip to the London Creature Shop for the fitting of the costume, casting, all that stuff.
Oh, okay. Well, when I got the job, I was completely and utterly broke. I mean, I was, you know, it was scary. And so I was kind of excited. Suddenly I got a job and I was going to actually, you know, earn a living of some kind. And they had given me per diem. And I spent the per diem to buy some food and to pay some bills. So when I got to London, I didn't really have money for a taxi. But I got there okay. I made some calls. And anyway, so it was interesting. I was blown away when I got into the room. Huge room. It's like a warehouse looking spot. And they were already in the process of sort of piecing together these Ninja Turtles with the mechanisms and the computers and the servos. And I mean, it was like they're all milling around and they're creating everyone, you know, and you're like, hi, and they're like, hey, you know, like, look at this. And they're like idiot savants. They're these like crazy professors. And they're, you know, it's like, it was great. It was like, it was NASA of puppets, you know? I mean, it was incredible. So I was really excited. And then fast forward, suddenly they're putting me in a body suit, you know, plaster, full body up to my head, completely dark, and this, to make, and the reason why they do it is to make your form, full body forms, because they actually made the costume fit to your actual body, right? So anyway, so it was an incredible experience, and being in London and Hampstead, it was like that energy there, and it was very creative, and you really had the feeling that this was something that was going to be special, you know what I mean? Because of all the special energy that these people had in the room, and like one after the other, you know, people that were making the leather straps for the people that are making the little elbow pads and people that were carving the shells. I mean, it was like, and they were all, it seemed to me at that point, just like geniuses, you know what I mean? And, and a lot of them had been with the Muppets, you know? And so I was just like this, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, I literally was like, De Niro, DeVault, I don't care, Henson, you know what I mean? Like I was, you know what I mean? Like I was starstruck by Henson's minions, you know what I'm saying? So that was my experience.
With working and actually getting to do that with Jim and everything,
yeah.
What was it like your first day on the set as a turtle?
I was really nervous. We had been rehearsing and rehearsing, and this type of work is, it really is an art form. It's a performance style, because you are physicalizing this character, and it's not just making it believable and strong and this filling the suit, but it's also playing for camera, which is already a skill without being in a suit, right?
Yeah.
But you're also working with a puppeteer or two behind the camera, or manipulating your mouth and your eyes. And so everyone has to be together on just like the subtle movement of your head, of, you know, and, you know, because you take for granted when you move your head and how your eyes shift and your focus. And so everyone has to be together, but that whole, and it's a choreography. I mean, it's hard to explain, but your body and head and your movement and where you look and how you say the line and breathing, because we normally breathe when we speak. So how do you do that with the turtle?
With a big shell and foam over your neck. And
yeah, but I mean, in terms of making it look like it's natural, you know?
Yeah.
So you're thinking about how the turtle breathes and how do you make it look like it took a breath. But just an exhale, I mean, that's three people working together, body, head, mouth, eye, movement. I give it up to those that, it's a miracle, actually, when it all comes together. I really believe that. And so, that never really came together. With my character, at least, I can't speak for any of the others, but my puppeteers and me, it didn't really, we were rehearsing and rehearsing and rehearsing. It didn't click for me. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't really get it yet. You know, it's not something you can, like, teach and articulate. It's something that organically happens. And it's communication with your puppeteers and you and, you know, on the line, you know, what's happening between the lines and around the lines. And so, first day, I was really nervous because of that. You know, it's like, oh man, I didn't want to fail. I didn't want to screw it up. I was really into it. I was very passionate about making this character come to life. And especially coming from the acting school that I did, which is very physical, I really appreciated, you know, the inside, the outside in, the physicality of having something come to life, the suspension of disbelief. So I was very nervous. And we were in the sewer. It was a pizza scene. Sorry. That's the next day. Next day was the nightmare, actually. But,
oh, okay.
But this is it was between me and Michelangelo waiting for the pizza to come down through the grating, right?
Yeah.
And we're like, and I remember the scene, you know, it's like, nice night. And we rehearsed the scene a lot. You know, Michelangelo, yeah. And it's a very subtle scene. But if you watch that scene between Donatello and Michelangelo waiting for the pizza and they're talking to each other and it's kind of touching, you know, in a sentimental turtle way, a lot of work went into that scene because we're sitting there, but all these little subtle movements with our heads and how we look at each other and respond and think about what the other person said, like it was highly choreographed. But I think that Misha and I, something clicked in the moment where a lot of it kind of got thrown out the window and it was just natural. We were all just kind of with each other. And it's like, you gotta understand, it's when you're doing a scene with two even, it's two super performers and two other puppeteers. You have like four other puppeteers, so it's like six people trying to do this dance together, to do this scene together. And it was pretty awesome because I think that we were happy with it, you know. And when I look at the movie again, I'm like, that was great. It's so simple, yet it works.
You know? Yeah.
Now the next day was a disaster. The next day we're in the sewer, and it's the whole opening sequence where all the turtles run in.
Yeah.
They run around. They go and they jump, freeze frame, Cowabunga.
Excellent.
I mean, that's all we did that day. Right. That's all we did that day. And it was like 46 takes, 48 takes, where you're running you don't even understand. It was like 140 degrees inside those things. And it was highly choreographed because you can only see underneath, you know, I mean, you could barely see. And you're running with four others in a choreographed way. One goes this way and he turns and one leaps and you high five and you jump, and I mean, you got to look like you're not blind and lost, which we were for 20 takes, right? I mean, it was like crazy, and we're slipping because it was a sewer set, and they had real water, and I mean, it was crazy. It was slippery, so they had
your legs off right up to here.
They had to take the legs off because we couldn't. We were tearing up the feet.
Oh,
and so around take okay. So and back then with the first movie, they had these cords, you know, like, I don't know how many, 12 cords that went to all the different servos in your head, and you could barely move your head, and it was heavy, and they were panicking about the time it's going to take to shoot this thing. And to take the head off and give us a break, at that point was, no, you can't take the head off. We got to keep moving. We got to keep going. It was really uncomfortable. I don't think he even protected the suit because I could feel like a sharp piece of wood digging into my groin every time I sat on it. I mean, it was like, it was just a nightmare. So take 14, and we had like dressers and there was production assistants and people helping out with each turtle. And I really needed something to drink. I really needed some water. And I didn't know how to ask at that point. We didn't really have a system or a plan. But I remember just kind of looking around and in my head, you know, I was just like, water! Like, some water! And so suddenly, and if I look down like this through my mouth, I can see the piece of someone's face if they wanted to communicate with me. And suddenly this appeared, this young lad whose face kind of looked up through the... goes, you need anything? You know, I could hear, you know, I was like,
yes, I would like some water. Water would be great. That would be awesome. Some water.
And he's like, huh? He's looking at me. Ah, I get to see this eyeball in the corner of her mouth going, ha! Ah. I was like, water! You're like, Coca-Cola?
Not water!
All right. You know, I could hear him scurrying off. I could hear, yeah, he wants some Coca-Cola. All right, so he... All right, so 30 seconds later, this Coke can shows up with a straw, a regular straw. The Coke can goes up against the ridge of the mouth, boink, right? So it stops, and the straw goes, like, right here. I'm like... Right? I'm like, you gotta be kidding. Like this, right? Right? And then suddenly it pulls out, and I hear, he's good. You know, like, what? I'm like, you know, no, I didn't get anything. So that's happened like six times. I'm now, they finally let us sort of like be on our hands and knees because this whole stool thing they made that they actually painted different colors was crazy. Didn't work. I mean, we're on it going, this is crazy. You know, so they took those away. And now we're on our hands and knees. And I remember hearing a whimper, you know, like a whimpering, like a little girl crying. And I was like, I gotta turn my head like this. And one of the Ninja Turtles was actually having a breakdown, was actually crying hysterically because he was like, because we've been in this thing for like 4 hours and we're like, I mean, you can understand, like drench, you know, like just sweat was just like coming down. I'm like totally, I mean, we're so hot, claustrophobic. Oh, and the skull cap inside the head was like, you know, like digging into our, skull. I mean, it was like so uncomfortable. You couldn't move your head because of these cords, and it was like loud, and the servos, and you can't see. But if you can see, you see people like being really jolly and happy in regular clothes. You know what I mean? Like you're looking through, and you're like, he's got, and I'm like, he's got a T-shirt on. Is that a cheeseburger he's enjoying? You know, and I'm like, oh yeah, I'm Donatello. This is great. I'd rather be cleaning up the place. You know what I mean? Like, God, give me a broom. Get me out of this thing. You know? Okay, you know, and then five takes later, I hear a thump, thump. But I'm on my hands and knees, and I'm like, seriously thinking, like, asking the producers to recommend like a psychologist. Do you know what I mean? Like seriously, like. I need to see a psychologist. And I was like, seriously thinking, should it be a Jungian psychologist or a Freudian psychologist? Do I want to talk about my mother? Do I want to draw with crayons? Do I want to dance? What kind of psychologist do I want? I need somebody to talk to. Like, seriously. But then I hear this thump, thump, thump. And I kind of like turn my head, because I can't turn my head, like this. And there's Josh Pice as Raphael. And he's hitting the sewer set, you know, like these are like very, you know, he's just slamming it, like he's lost it. He's like, bang, bang, like he's like, wow, like he was like George Foreman, you know what I'm saying? Like he was like, I mean, it was he was just hitting it hard, and I could hear him, I could just hear this faint like, yeah, like he was like screaming, he's like hitting the sewer, right? And I was just like, turning my head back, oh, Jesus Christ, yeah, what are we doing? And then I have, you know, I'm looking at Misha, and he just looks defeated. Misha's like, in this very strange fetal position, he's just like, you know, like he's like, Michelangelo is just praying. he's like hallucinating, you know. Misha's just like, seriously having an acid flashback. He's just like, oh my God, right? And then the only turtle that was kind of normal at this point was Leonardo, Dave Foreman, right? I was like, what's Dave doing? Like, God, we're all suffering. Where's Dave? You know, so I kind of like scooted over and I kind of looked through my eyes, you know, like, and there's Dave, who's like, it was like a, you know, a stunt guy, an Asian stunt guy from London, very cool, family guy, you know, kind of all England, you know. And I love David, but, you know, but I finally found him, and Leonardo was just kind of like this. You know, like, he was a stuntman, so he was like, Leonardo looked like he was loving life. Like, he was just standing there like an action figure. Like, no issue. Like, Michelangelo was like, oh my God, Judas. You know, and then you have, you know, then you have Josh Pais, who's like, boom, like he's training to take on Joe Frazier, you know, and I'm just like in misery, you know, like looking for a gun, depressed in my temple, you know, and like, and there's Dave Foreman as Leonardo. This is great. Love it. Love making movies in suits. So, you know, so that was the second day, so.
Do you have any bloopers from either of the two movies that you would like to share that, like, happened on camera or something that was hilarious? Or...
Okay, well, when we did the Barbara Walters special, we did the interview with Barbara.
Where he cried all over?
So you know about that story?
I don't know how that happened. I just know it happened.
Well, the mechanism broke. I mean, we were supposed to be... we rehearsed this whole thing, and she asked Donatello, oh, we lost our parents or whatever. It's supposed to be like a tear that's supposed to, like, trickle out of the eye. And just have like, and we're supposed to, you know, supposed to have like this little, you know, oh yeah, this is really bad, you know, this kind of has the, you know, like what, like a lot of the people do on the Barbara Walters show, they kind of lose it, but they restrain it because they have control of their emotions that are free at the same time. So we're trying to do that, and something broke in the mechanism, and just water started gushing through. Right, so I had to like, so I was like, I just went with it. I was like, okay, I'm having a nervous breakdown. You know what I mean? Like, okay, you know? So, I mean, there you go.
What was one of your favorite things about working on the first Ninja Turtle movie?
Meeting those, hanging out with those puppeteers. David Rudman, who worked on Sesame Street, and David Greenaway, who did the eyes for Yoda in Star Wars, you know what I mean? Like, David Greenaway did the eyes for Yoda in Star Wars, like, you know what I mean? Like, that was really cool.
Which set from the Ninja Turtle movies was your favorite to work on?
Our home, I think. Our home.
First or second movie?
First movie.
The first movie?
I think I enjoyed it the most because... You don't see a lot of it on film, but it was the turtles just kind of hanging and chilling in their environment on their kind of makeshift found object furniture from scavenging in the sewer. And we did a lot of rehearsals where we're just like walking around and, you know, you're going to get the pizza, you know, whatever. I mean, I know it sounds kind of ridiculous, but but I mean, it was... We really kind of got into character.
Are you still friends with anyone who worked on the Turtle movie with you?
Sam Rockwell is like who plays the one of the thugs. That is like my best friend. He's like my brother.
You went from being a turtle to being Rockstar. A dinosaur.
Yes.
Now, did you go and try out for that, or did they approach you?
No, we had auditions for that. Yeah. I actually had to fight for an audition for that.
Really?
Yeah. I almost didn't get it. They wanted to cast this girl as Robbie. But for some reason, that didn't work out. And so it was like roll of the dice. I mean, it was like, you know. I was excited to do it. I knew about dinosaurs coming down the pipe when we were doing the second movie. You know, and was told about it. And you should get an audition for this, Leif. And hope I get one, and I did get one, but it was, I think it was after they lost, they did this whole series of auditions without any of us from the Turtles being a part of it, and then I guess something happened with this girl, and she fell out, and then I got an audition. And
was the costumes much different for you guys, going from being a turtle with a shell to a dinosaur with a tail?
Like, it was really, the tail informed, like, how I was going to walk as Robbie. It was a big deal in terms of Robbie having this kind of, you know, because Robbie would just glide around. But it was about, I didn't get that until I actually, because we did all these rehearsals without the costume on.
Yeah.
Let's find a walk, Leif. And this guy, Ponsmar, was kind of being our... walk instructor or something, and let's do another walk, Leif. Let's walk around. Hey, and so I was like, yeah, okay. I mean, we can do this, but you don't really know the character until you're in
the costume.
The costume, where you're feeling the weight of it and the elements of it. You know, so all that previous work, the producers could have saved thousands of dollars and just brought us in when the costumes were ready. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, I mean, weeks of rehearsing and walking around a gym mat on a soundstage. Weeks!
Did you have a favorite episode of Dinosaurs?
The werewolf episode was my favorite episode. The werewolf episode. It was a lot of fun. You know, I mean, it was already, you know, Dinosaurs is already satire. It was already the Honeymooners and blah, blah, blah. And this is kind of taking satire on satire.
Yeah.
You know, and so it was fun. Yeah, it was fun. Yeah. But my favorite thing to do, and the favorite moment I ever had on Dinosaurs is that they were doing an ABC promotion that they do, you know, and they kind of take all the one character from each show. And so what the promotion was promoting this Michael Jackson concert, I think it was, or something to do with Michael Jackson. I think it was like the tour or something like that. And so they had all the shows on ABC, one person danced like Michael Jackson, did like a dance. They did like the moonwalk and so they picked Robbie to do this Michael Jackson thing. And I could do anything I wanted. And it was like I had like 12 seconds or something like that. And they had the music and someone from the creature shop made a glove, and I did this whole Michael Jackson dance, and it was so much fun. It was like that to me was like the moment.
What are some other projects you've done after Dinosaurs?
I did Monkey Bone, played Cyclops and Monkey Bone. I did a bunch of gorilla movies. I did George of the Jungle, and I did. The movie I'm most proud of is this movie called Born to Be Wild, which is about this. It's about this boy and this gorilla that he saves from this charlatan, you know, this carny that was just gonna abuse this gorilla and travel around with him. And so he, it's like a road movie. He kidnaps me. And it's just me and this kid. And he teaches me, I had learned some sign language, like the girl they taught it's based on that, you know, a true story about that. I mean, this is not a true story, but the premise that you can teach a gorilla sign language.
Is there anything you would like to say to the Turtle fans who grew up watching the movies, who really appreciate your work that you did on the films?
The Ninja Turtles are cool. The way it came about, was... I think magical in itself, you know, and I think that, you know, you should believe in the ninja way. I believe you should believe in the ninja way. The ninja way is not an original idea, but I think they carry it out in a unique way. And be good to each other.
Thank you, everyone, for watching Cowabunga Corner, and thank you, Leif, for joining us.
All right.
One last thing is, would you please take us out with a cowabunga to the fans?
Okay. Cowabunga!